Good evening. Good evening. Honorable Padma Shri, how do I call him? What do they call him in Kerala now? Mamuka? You know? No megastar, power star and all that there? No? Big brother. Mamuka means big brother, is it? So I guess big brother to all of us. Not just Malayalis, but all of us. Thank you, sir. Padma Shri Mammootty Garu. Honorable Minister for Home, Labour and Employment, Shri Nayani Narasimha Reddy Garu. And the man who is celebrating his birthday today. Sir, you are younger than me by one day. The chair, the MD of NMDC, Shri Bajendra Nathan. John, you stole a lot of my lines. You actually didn't leave me with much to say, but thank you, John. John Brittus. Libby Benjamin, a man in a hurry always. Good seeing you. Mamidi Hari Krishna Garu. And to all my Malayali friends in Hyderabad and in various parts of Telangana. I wanted to say a couple of things and I wrote them down because I didn't want to screw up, so I actually wrote them down. Ellarku namaskara, that's number one. And I have one more thing to say, hold on, let me say this right. Because I'm not sure if I'm going to say it right. Ningal Malayali kale snehikkunu. I just wanted to say we love our Malayali friends because we have lots of them. In fact, we have around 4 lakh Malayalis in Telangana. And as we all know, you've contributed immensely, not just to Telangana alone, but to the entire country today, we all know. Many, many school teachers, IT professionals, and many medical, you know, many in the medical field in the form of nurses, not just in Telangana and Hyderabad, but across the country, you have contributed immensely to the growth of this country, and we sincerely do love you and we sincerely do appreciate all the service that has been rendered by Malayali community across the world as well. I have a lot of Malayali friends. In fact, two of my roommates in US, when I was actually going to school there, were Malayalis. You know, one was, they always used to fight with each other, that's a different story. One was a guy called Jojo Thomas, wherever he is today. I think he must be in the US. Then there was another gentleman called Matthew Chirail Kuriakos. So these two gentlemen, you know, always used to fight about who's the bigger star, Mamuka or, you know, the other gentleman, you know, I don't have to name him. So that was the fight that was always going on. But you know what I'm always thrilled about? When I became Minister for Panchayati Raj, initial days, this was about 4 years ago, and when I wanted to really introduce some reforms, some wonderful new initiatives in Panchayati Raj, everybody told me one thing. They said, you don't have to look far. Just go to Kerala, study the model there. Panchayati Raj system in Kerala is exemplary, and you should just blindly copy and paste. So I have gone to Kerala, and when I've seen the state and what you have done, I must truly compliment the governments. I know it could be UDF, LDF, I think they keep switching every 5 years. But I think because Malayalis are very, very smart and you don't want the same government to continue forever. So no matter who the government was, because the people are wise, I think government after government has lifted, raised the bar and has certainly helped Kerala being the first state in the country to achieve 100% literacy, to achieve number one rank on many, many counts. So Malayalis, wherever you live in the world, you must be absolutely proud, you must be absolutely devoted to the wonderful things your state has been doing over the last several decades. But we are catching up, I must also tell you, because in the survey that was released recently, 3 days ago, by the Public Affairs Index, an institution based in Bangalore, headed by no less a person than former chairman of ISRO, Mr. Kasturi Rangan, they had released a report on 30 different sectors and 100 different indicators. And they said, of course, Kerala is ranked number one in the country in governance, but Telangana is not too far. We are number three. So we are catching up. We are catching up. And when I say we, like our Honorable Home Minister said, all of us who belong to Telangana are catching up with all of them in Kerala. I think you agree with me on that. You are more Telangana today than I think you are more Keralite, is what I would like to believe. So therefore, respecting your sentiments, when Libby and the entire group, you know, of the Confederation of Telugu Region Malayali Associations, led by Libby and very, you know, suitably aided by many, many of his wonderful colleagues here, when they have requested our Honorable Chief Minister, he was not only kind enough to grant a sum of rupees 1 crore, but also, you know, gave the land that was required. It was given on lease, and I'm sure the construction will also begin soon. And the goodwill gesture was also reciprocated by Government of Kerala, who has kindly consented for construction of a Telangana Bhavan in Shabarimala, and which I hope will also happen very, very soon. As you all know, a city like Hyderabad, which has global aspirations, which has aspirations to become a global city, a truly global city, has to respect, has to assimilate, has to imbibe all cultures, all religions, and all languages. So therefore, we are proud of the 4 lakh Malayalis in the state of Telangana. And as a mark of respect, as you all know, the government of Telangana has been officially conducting the Onam festival. In the language and culture department of government of Telangana has been hosting the Onam festival every year right here in Ravindra Bharati. I must also tell you 2 more things before we talk about the Innotech Awards. When I actually met Mr. Mammootty, of course, I had a fanboy moment also, because like you, like many, many of you, I'm a huge admirer of his wonderful work over the last several decades. And he's a man who doesn't age, of course. He's found some potion. He's found something which he's not sharing with us, which is allowing him to be the way he is. So when I met him, I honestly asked him. I said, is Dulquer your brother or is he your son? So, sir, I think you are seriously giving him some competition to Dulquer Salman. And next time I meet Dulquer, I'm telling him that also. I honestly admired, when I met the man, I admired his simplicity, his humility. He did not have to come see me. I said, you know, a letter would be enough. But he insisted on meeting me. And I was more than happy to meet him, because you don't get to meet legends every often. So I was more than happy to meet him. And when he met me, I realized that he's a man of very, very uncommon wisdom. Because not only did he talk about media, not only did he talk about technology, he spoke about agriculture, he spoke about the problems that our country is facing today. So he's a man who's definitely connected to the grassroots. He offered a lot of valuable piece of advice, which I most certainly will be happy to carry to our Honorable Chief Minister as well. But more importantly today, the reason why we are all here, cherishing innovation in technology, cherishing solutions which are coming up across our country, not just in Telangana, not just in IT capitals like Hyderabad and Bengaluru and other cities. I think innovation, no matter where it happens, in the rural India or the urban India, they need to be supported, they need to be cherished. Because very often, as you know, most innovators, the biggest challenge for them is to ensure that they continue to strive to succeed till they actually hit the successful note. So I think what Kairali Group is doing today and its chairman, Sri Mammootty, is doing today is essentially ensuring that all the innovators, no matter where they are from, which part of India they are from, they are being recognized, they are being respected, and they are being given a chance to shine and to make their own, you know, to make their own role in the limelight. So I do believe that this is a great step from Kairali Group, and I do wish what John had mentioned with respect to a partnership between Kerala and Telangana, we're more than happy, because as you all know, the IT industry in Hyderabad has matured over the last 20 odd years. So now we are looking at a lot of emerging solutions, emerging technologies, and we continue to grow at a much faster rate than the national average growth rate also. We are more than happy to support Kerala, because we already are supporting Goa, we are supporting Tripura, we are supporting Delhi, and we would be thrilled to support Kerala as well, and we would be happy to enter a partnership, because stronger the states, stronger our country. So therefore, I do look forward to a fruitful partnership between Government of Kerala and Government of Telangana in taking the IT initiatives forward in Kerala and various parts of Kerala as well. Once again, my good wishes to all my Malayali friends, and we will continue to assist you. We will continue to grow together with you in Telangana, and I hope there will come a day when Telangana will be ranked number 1 jointly with Kerala, if not, you know, next to Kerala. Thank you very much.